Hi, the Mud Broker here. A few days ago, Artemis Fair posted a video about Kevin and Elizabeth Schott, a Paradise, California couple who have been charged with beating their 7-year-old daughter to death with a length of quarter-inch PVC water supply hose. The Schottses were practitioners of a system of child discipline and training promoted by a fundamentalist preacher named Michael Pearl and his wife Debbie. The Pearls earn somewhere around $2 million a year, selling books and doing seminars on various Christian family topics, but their biggest selling book is To Train Up a Child, an instruction manual for torturing your offspring in a biblically sound manner. I provided links to a couple of articles by Lynn Harris in Salon Magazine, which provide some excellent background on the Pearls and their ministry. The Pearls make their living off the fact that for most fundamentalist and evangelical Christians, corporal punishment of their children is a big part of their identity. It's a point of pride with these folks that rather than using timeouts and the touchy-feely positive reinforcement like in the ungodly secular world, they soundly thrash their kiddies just like God told them to. Providing an easy-to-read instruction manual with clear directions for the best way to torture your child, and with all the theological heavy lifting already done to justify it for you, has been a very lucrative business for the Pearls. And make no mistake about it, the systems the Pearls have developed, for all its biblical boilerplate and claims that it's the loving thing to do for your kids, is nothing more than a textbook example of how to break a prisoner's will through mental and physical torture. The stated goal of the punishment is to get the child to voluntarily surrender his will. I provided a link to the Pearls website. When you get there, click on the tab that says Child Training, then click on the rod, and finally scroll down to In Defense of Biblical Chastisement. In part 1, Michael Pearl gives a long-winded biblical justification for flogging your child. In the second part, he finally gets down to brass tacks about his technique. I won't go into the details, it's better just to read it for yourself. But in a nutshell, what Pearl recommends is that the first sign of rebellion and willfulness, take your child, restraining him if he resists, and whip that little heathen until he utterly submits to your will. Punishments like this are most necessary between the ages of 2 and 4, and they serve a twofold purpose. First, it establishes your absolute authority as a parent over the child, and second, it prepares the child to surrender his will to the absolute authority of God later in life. You heard me right. This slimy motherfucker and his wife are making millions of dollars a year selling books and giving seminars promoting the indoctrination of preschool children by means of physical torture. They need to be exposed to much greater and much harsher public scrutiny than what they've been getting, and that's exactly what I plan to do, and I invite you, my gentle viewers, to join with me. I propose we use what I'll call the Mel Brooks theory. This isn't verbatim, but the gist of the story is that years ago, an interviewer asked Brooks why he worked some sort of reference to the Nazis into almost all of his movies. Brooks answered that he did it because the Nazis were evil, and that by refusing to mention them out of fear or revulsion only added to their power and mystique. But by making them a laughingstock and holding them up to ridicule, that mystique is stripped away. Not only that, but the only way to truly destroy somebody is to laugh at them. And that's what I hope to do with the Pearls. To that end, I'm asking everyone out there watching this video who has a mind to do so to make a video of their own about the Pearls. Pwn them, mock them, ridicule them, whatever it takes to bring these assholes the kind of attention they really deserve. To get you started, here's a couple of nuggets a quick look at the articles on their website turned up. The first one comes from a book review written by Michael Pearl. He blames the upsurge on autism, among other things, on yeast in our diets. The other one is an article by Debbie Pearl called Barbie Dolls or Baby Dolls. In it, she warns mothers not to let young girls play with Barbie dolls because later in life they'll have strange, sexually compelling thought life and lustful daydreams. Let me read you a couple of sentences. Would you invite a 20-year-old over-endowed model to come into your daughter's room to be admired for her body and dress? Would you allow your daughter to help her dress? Now I know there's somebody watching this video that could just have a field day with a gem like that.